Let's be honest, I'm just reviewing this because I'm a shameless sellout. And my last review of a movie by the same guy got about 100 times my normal views. So my man Timo Tjahjanto, whose name I probably still shouldn't try to pronounce, is back. This time with a horror movie. Now what I want from a horror movie is a bit different from an action movie. I want it to be creepy, scary and fun. And if the story is good, that's a bonus. So is this creepy, scary and fun? Yeah, I'd say so. And the story is actually pretty coherent. At least by horror movie standards. The very, very end gets a little weird. But for the most part it makes sense. Now it's not really doing anything new, it's basically a demonic possession movie. And it actually reminded me a lot of The Nun, in more ways than one. For instance, the demon design looks a lot like The Nun. And there's the ritual and the devil is involved, and most of it takes place in one spot. But this thing is like The Nun on steroids. Except, you know, actually good. Now, I wouldn't call this a great movie. I mean, it does what it's supposed to do. But again, it's not the most original movie out there. And the story's just kinda whatever. It's definitely not the worst thing I've seen. And it actually makes sense. And acting's good. I can't really complain. And a lot of the practical effects were really good too. And there's actually a few shots here and there that were great. But it's a low-budget movie and it shows. Take the CGI for instance. Some of it is okay, but some of it's just not up to par with what I expect in 2018. Like there's this CGI tongue, and a few other things too, that just don't look good at all. And overall I have to say that the cinematography isn't that great either. But I wouldn't call it bad. It's really just that I'm so used to even low-budget indie movies looking stunning, that when I see a movie that doesn't look that great, it looks pretty bad in comparison. But it's perfectly watchable. Now, when it comes to the actual makeup effects, I'm a bit torn, because some of it is top-notch. But then you have a few versions of the demon that just look kinda lame. Looks too clean, too much like makeup. Almost like a demonic geisha. But overall I'd say there's a lot more good makeup than bad. Now as far as the scary and creepy stuff goes, I like that a lot. Some of the stuff was less interesting than other stuff, but a lot of it was great. They did the usual things you'd expect, but there weren't actually that many straight up jump scares. And the creepy stuff was really creepy. And they did a few clever things here and there too. A few misdirects that caught me off guard. It was fun. And got pretty intense a few times. Especially that one scene in the kitchen, like 45 minutes into it, I thought that was excellent. And what I like about this movie is that it doesn't play around. It gets straight into it and the demon actually does things. It's actually dangerous. It doesn't just run around scaring people. It bites and claws and tries to kill you. And you know, that actually seems to be a rarity these days. So I appreciate that. Now the issue with going all out early on is that you then have to keep it up. And it did a fairly good job. But by the end of it I was really ready for it to wrap up. They could have cut down that last sequence a little bit. I got the point about halfway through. But then it just kept going. Now we're only talking like 5 or 10 minutes here. So it's not a huge issue, but yeah, I would have been happier if they just wrapped it up a tiny bit quicker. But as a whole, I like this thing. It's an effective, fun horror movie. I had a good time with it. So would I recommend it? Sure, why not? Check it out. Or don't. I'm not your dad.